Let's talk about sharing workload. It's something that came up recently through a couple of messages that I got from some folks. They complained about their current work environments, and they complained about how some of their leaders have said, always give the work to the busiest person, right? Because they'll be most efficient and most effective at getting it done because they don't have a lot of time to spare, which to me is a troubling way of leading a team or managing the workload. Now, I'm aware that it's very difficult. Let's say if you have five direct reports, if you have five senior leaders, seven or eight, you pick a number. It's very difficult to say those five will each have 20% of the responsibilities at any given moment in any given day. That's just not how life works. That's not how work works. And therefore, in some cases, some of them might have more areas or more departments under them. Therefore, their volume of responsibilities will certainly grow. So maybe one of those five will never go below 30 or 40% alone because they are the, let's say, senior most individual and they have that much to do and so on. And then others will never go above 20 or 25% because of the scope of their responsibilities. Now, having said that, it is really important to be intentional not to overload any single individual or any small section or group of people while others are idling. Look for cross-functional training, look for opportunities, look for them to be of value and service to these team members and these colleagues. They might be eating from a plate that is overflowing, if you will, right? But having five individuals or five leaders of areas and having everybody have 20% responsibilities at all times is impractical and nearly impossible in my experience. Again, one man's point of view. Now, on the other hand, it's really unfair to have one person do 50 or 60% of the work while others are doing 7 or 2 or 8% of contributions. So be mindful how you staff your responsibilities and your teams. Be mindful how you assign those responsibilities, those projects, and those initiatives, and provide for an opportunity, because sometimes you're going to get stuck in just getting things done in the execution mode, so you won't have enough time to look up and truly see where you're going at times and how this load and then these responsibilities are shared and distributed. So build into your process a feedback loop and mechanism for your direct reports where they can feel comfortable to come to you and say, I just want to let you know that I have a lot on my plate right now, right? Or sure, I can take that on, but is there anything else that I can maybe pause for a bit, for a week or two or a month, while we take on to this new thing? That's generally a good cue that something's going on. Either you've asked them to do too much, or they might have other challenges that you're not aware of, and therefore they need some more time, some more space, and maybe a little bit of more grace from you as a leader of that team. Be mindful, talk to people, ask questions, listen and learn, and allow them to provide and share feedback as to how your leadership style is impacting their contributions and their performance as a team. Have a wonderful day. I wish you all the best. As always, if this is the first video you have seen, please consider subscribing below, leaving a comment on the topic I just covered, and sharing it across your networks. Have a great day.